This is a stegosaurus, this is an iguanodon, and this is a megalosaurus. However, if you go back only 200 years ago, their reconstruction is as follows. There are many twists and turns hidden until these dinosaurs became what they are today. The story of the dinosaur reconstruction begins now. The year is 1676. British naturalist Robert Plot found a strange-looking bone in a quarry. The bones looked like human testicles, but they were the first dinosaur fossils. But at that time, there was no word or concept indicating dinosaurs, so he thought it was the thigh bone of an elephant or a giant. Of course, it was later discovered that the owner of this bone was a megalosaurus. Dinosaur fossils were discovered in 17th century, but dinosaur research had begun in 19th century. And at the heart of it was Gideon Mantell, a doctor and amateur paleontologist. Gideon Mantell's wife gave a fossil of animal teeth to her husband, who was interested in collecting fossils. Mantell discovered that these teeth resemble those of an iguana, and named it iguanodon, meaning iguana's teeth. And just like iguanas are mostly vegetarians, he thought iguanodons would be giant vegetarian reptiles. So, he drew a reconstruction of it in a similar way to a lizard. Then, he wrote to the French biologist Georges Cuvier for advice.
Hey, Mr. Cuvier, how about the restoration I drew?
Oh, what a big animal, like a rhinoceros.
Oh, a big rhinoceros-like animal?
Mantell was an Englishman, and he mistranslated French. He had an unknown conical fossil, among the additional fossils of iguanodon he had purchased. He misinterpreted Cuvier's opinion and attached the fossil to the nose of an iguanodon, like a rhinoceros. This fossil, as you may know, was later turned out to be the thumb of an iguanodon. Moreover, it was not only the iguanodon that was restored in such a foolish way. Megalosaurus was depicted as a mixture of a crocodile and a wolf. Hylaeosaurus is known to be like this nowadays, but was restored like a land iguana. Not surprisingly, even Richard Owen, a prominent paleontologist at that time, claimed that all three animals mentioned above must have walked on four legs, so there was no disagreement with this restoration. Meanwhile, Owen discovered that the legs of these reptiles all stretched downwards unlike current reptiles. So, he thought that it needed a new name. Finally, in 1842, these animals were given the name dinosaur, which means dreadful lizard in Greek. It was the moment when the name dinosaur was born. Richard Owen, who won the title as a dinosaur scientist, was asked by the British royal family to display a dinosaur in the garden of Crystal Palace. Owen, together with Benjamin Hopkins, a famous sculptor at the time, made a real-size dinosaur model out of cement. The dinosaur model was so huge that at the end of 1853, Hopkins invited paleontologists to dine on a replica of an iguanodon he had made. And the dinosaurs exhibited in the Crystal Palace still remain. However, they were all walking on four legs like an elephant, and dragging their long tails to the ground. Then, in 1850, in New Jersey, a fossil that completely overturned the dinosaur restoration plan was discovered. It was a hadrosaurus. In its fossil site, all the bones of hind legs and forelegs of Hadrosaurus were found. Surprisingly, the hind leg bones were much longer than the forelegs. This was an evidence that Hadrosaurus could walk on only with their two hind legs. It was a discovery that dropped a reputation of Owen, who was prominent for quadrupedal walking. In addition, in 1878, in a rural area of England, a lot of fossils of an iguanodon with short arms and long hind legs were discovered. And from then, all existing dinosaur restorations were changed to walking on two legs. Even Stegosaurus walks on two legs in a painting restored in 1884. The thorns and corrugated plates are in incorrectly positioned since the fossils were scattered all over the floor at the time it was found. But there was one thing paleontologists did not give up on dinosaur reconstruction, and it is a tail. It was due to the stereotype that reptiles have to drag their tails to the ground. So, if you look at the reconstruction of Megalosaurus or Iguanodon made in 19th century, they are standing with their tails attached to the ground like a kangaroo. This stereotype was so severe that some paleontologists artificially created shape of dinosaur's tailbone. In 1892, paleontologist Louis Dallo, while recovering a skeleton of an iguanodon, broke the tailbones to restore them to a dragging position. And although a variety of dinosaurs were discovered in the 1900s, including quadrupeds like Triceratops, Brachiosaurus, the tail was still drawn with a dragging tail. In addition, most paleontologists at the beginning of the 20th century believed that the reason why dinosaurs went extinct was because they were stupid and dull. For this reason, dinosaurs were often depicted as slow and dull creatures hanging around wetland. However, in the 1970s, the traditional view of dinosaurs is completely overturned. And the dinosaur Renaissance era began, and the protagonist who opened the door was Deinonychus, meaning terrible claw. Professor Jonathan argued that these light and agile dinosaurs were nimble hunters. Based on the fact that several Deinonychus were discovered with Thanatosaurus, they were inferred to be clever dinosaurs that even hunted in groups. The skeleton of Deinonychus was similar to that of Archaeopteryx, so he made a radical claim that modern birds may have evolved from dinosaurs. In addition, no traces of dinosaur tails were found in the fossil site of dinosaur footprints. And the opinion that dinosaurs must have kept their tails up while walking gained academic recognition. From then, dinosaurs began to be described as dynamic animals keeping their tails up. John Ostrom's earlier hypothesis that dinosaurs evolved into the birds was ridiculed at the first time, but discovery of the feathered dinosaur in 1996 made a change. Starting with Cynosauropteryx, Protarchaeopteryx, Epidexipteryx, and Cynornithosaurus, dozens of feathered dinosaur fossils have been found, and the theory that birds are grandchildren of dinosaurs is also widely accepted. In fact, the appearance of dinosaurs that we are familiar with nowadays may also be a prejudice. The book All Yesterdays, written by British paleontologists, contains pictures that break the stereotype of current dinosaur reconstructions. Therizinosaurus is covered in abundant feathers instead of emphasizing the traditional claws, Triceratops with prickly hairs, and Stegosaurus with a distinctively large penis, since the pelvis prevents the male from riding on the female's back. Leolinosaurus, which lived in Australia, is described as a cute creature wearing bouncy coat adapted to the cold climate. The authors wrote this book to inform that the current reconstructions are not necessarily true and can be changed at any time with new scientific discoveries. In the distant future, how will our descendants evaluate today's reconstruction of dinosaurs? Will more sophisticated technology in the future show the real shape of a dinosaur different from today? Thanks for watching, and subscriptions and likes are a motivation to continuing this channel.